Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Yesterday we started talking about how to import text files into Excel and talked about the difference between a fixed width file that looks like this and a delimited file that looks like this with the commas. Today we want to talk about how to actually get that fixed width file into Excel. I'll switch over to Excel here. You want to go to the File, Open command, and at the bottom of the Open dialog box, change the files of type to be a text file. You'll be able to browse to and find your .txt file. Click Open. Now immediately, Excel will launch into the text import wizard. And then the very first step, you have to choose whether your data is delimited or fixed width. Now here in the preview, we can see really well that the data is in fact fixed width. So we'll click Next. Step two is where we define where each column begins. Now Excel takes a crack at guessing at this, but unfortunately they only look at the first few rows and they don't always get it right. You should look at each field and make sure that it's correct. In this case, remember that we have a field that has the apartment number, and that's not filled in on most records. Well, Excel wasn't able to detect that that's actually a field. So we want to add a new line. If I want to add a new line right here to the left of the A, I'll click, and it'll put the line in. Now, if I would put the line in the wrong place, it's easy to take an existing line and drag it to a new location, or if Excel had accidentally put an extra line in, you can get rid of the line by double-clicking it. We'll scroll over to the right and make sure everything looks good. Now, for some reason here at the end of my data set, I have an unprintable character. If I add a new line between the zip code and the unprintable character, I'll be able to get rid of those characters in the next step. We go on to step three, and this is the step where people tend to get into a little bit of trouble. For each field, you're supposed to choose whether it should be general, text, a date, or should be something that should not be imported. Well, that unprintable character at the end definitely is something that we don't want to import, so I'll choose that field and click Do Not Import Skip. Some people will say, well, the name is definitely text, so I want to change that to text, but I want to caution you against that. Once you use the text setting when you're importing a field, that column will now just be cursed. You won't be able to enter any formulas in that column if you choose text, so you should really only use text when you desperately need to. The reason that you would desperately need to is in a field such as a zip code, where you're going to have a leading zero. In this case, this zip code, 01234, if I would import that as general, I would lose the leading zero. So I want to change the zip code field to be a text field to make sure that I don't lose the leading zeros. Now, a few other options that we have here. We could go into advanced if any of our negative numbers have the minus sign on the right-hand side. We can solve that problem there. Or if this file came from a country in Europe where they use commas instead of decimal places, we could also handle that setting under advanced. Right now I'm ready to go, so I'll click finish, and Excel will bring in the file. It doesn't make the columns wide enough, so you might want to go through, choose your columns, and use format column autofit in order to make the columns wide enough. Now you'll notice that everything looks pretty good. Most of our apartment numbers are not filled in, and we kind of expected that. Down here, the zip code, it did successfully show us the zip code with the leading zero. Now, let me just show you what happens. Remember, the zip code was the one column that we used as a text column. If I insert a new row and put a formula here, equal 2 plus 2, instead of showing me the formula, Excel actually just puts in the text. It's very frustrating. You would have to go back, select the whole column, use format cells, and change the format from text to general. Even that doesn't solve the problem. You now have to go back to those formulas and re-enter them, equal 2 plus 2, to get the result. That's why I really try and avoid using the text type when I'm importing a file into Excel. Hey, there you have it. Tomorrow, we'll talk about how to deal with a file that has delimiters. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you tomorrow for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.